Hello everyone. Minasan konnichiwa. It's been a while since I made my last video. I'd like to follow the series on the kanjis. Today I'd like to see the perspective from a same combination of characters with different readings and different meanings. Without further ado, let's take a look at the following examples. Example 1. たった10分間の出馬だったが、彼は十分な働きをした。One more time. たった10分間の出馬だったが、彼は十分な働きをした。The translation is, he announced his candidacy in only 10 minutes, but did a great job. You can see that examples in the explanation page, part in my YouTube page. Okay, example 2.
日本列島が今年一番の寒気に覆われた翌日。風邪をひいて一日中寒気がした。
One more time.
日本列島が今年一番の寒気に覆われた翌日、風邪をひいて一日中寒気がした。
Japan is covered by the coldest frost this year and I felt cold in the following day. Example 3.
分別のある人間なら、ゴミはきちんと分別して出すべきだ。
One more time. 分別のある人間なら、
ゴミはきちんと分別して出すべきだ。
Which means, if you're a person with discernment, you should separate the trash properly and put it out. Okay, example 1, we have the kanjis for 10 and minute, so 10 and 分, which when read 10 minutes, they read 10分. And here we actually have a hint, because we have kan, which means duration of time, so 10分 kan, during 10 minutes.So when it relates to duration or time, of course, it would be read like a 10分. And in the final part of the sentence, we have 十分. And actually, we have a hint for that because we have the na, which means na, ke yoshi, or adjective ending in na. So 十分 na hataraki. So great job. So his work was enough. So here is 十分 na. So we have with the same kanjis.10分 and 十分 with different meanings, of course. In example 2, we have 一番の寒気. So we have the kanjis for cold, 寒い, and 気, feeling. So 寒気 in this context here means just frost. And in the end of the sentence, we have 寒気. So cold, you feel cold. After, of course, you got a cold, you're not going to feel hot, so you feel cold, 寒気. So we have different meanings here and different readings.And for example 3, we have an interesting example because both mean actually separate, but the first, 分別 means separation of, the way I see it is abstract things, so ideas, for instance, so it means understanding, 分別, discernment. And the last part of the sentence is 分別, which means to separate physical things, so 分別 and 分別. They are similar but totally different at the same time, so...I hope this was helpful, so you can understand kanjis better, and wait for your comments and suggestions for other videos. Thank you so much for watching. 見ていただいてありがとうございました。See you. 失礼します。